Jai Sachidanand. I bow to pure soul within you, everybody. Jai Sachidanand to everybody. So yesterday you have taken Jnan, self-realization. Now we have to keep that awareness. I am pure soul. And the Phi Agna is explained. It is for protection of awareness of pure soul. If we practice Phi Agna every day, every phases, so that will help you to remain in a stage of pure soul. Any living person, we will see by two viewpoint, by relative viewpoint pecking, or any relation, mother, auntie, father, uncle, by real viewpoint, pure soul. So see, every living creature, dog or cat or birds, by relative viewpoint, cat, real viewpoint, pure soul. So inner pure soul, in every living creature, we will observe by practicing Phi Agna. In our office also, boss or colleague or assistant, we will see inside pure soul. Then I am pure soul, and whatever name is separate from you, so keep to separation between body complex and pure soul, and see everybody as a pure soul and body complex separate. Then whatever happen is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence. Nobody is doer, nobody is individual doer. Whatever happen, something good, then we are taking credit, oh, I have done so and so good work. Something bad, then we are blaming on others. That now we don't want to see fault of any person. Whatever happen, pure soul is not doer at all. And physical body and scientific circumstantial evidence together, whatever happen is correct. Nobody is doer for that. Whatever happen, positive or negative, success or failure, we don't want to give any blame to any others. But it is a result of scientific circumstantial evidence. Why this result came? Nobody's doer. Due to our past karma, we cannot get result directly, but our karma attracts scientific circumstantial evidence and gives result. So nobody is responsible for our karma. We should not give any blame. We have to now understood, we can understand that I am pure soul and Deepak is separate. File 1. So Mr. X is separate, he is pure soul. Whatever happened between Mr. X and Mr. Deepak, it is a result of scientific circumstances. And he is one of the evidence. He is given my own karma as a result. So nobody is responsible. So whatever physical things is relative things is governed by scientific circumstantial evidence. Relative means whatever we are observing by five senses, so everything is relative and is governed by scientific circumstantial evidence. So on single evidence we cannot blame. Result. So whatever result comes, and really it is due to our ignorant state, whatever we have charged karma, we are getting result in next life by scientific circumstantial evidence. Whatever families and friends and relatives we are getting in this life, so it is a karmic account of attachment, hatred or affection. So now we want to finish all karmic account with equanimity. So this is file. So we say my wife, my husband, my children, these are files. We don't want to say them, you are file. But by whatever relation, my husband, my wife, my children, my father, mother, my boss, my colleague, like that we can say in worldly life. But inside we have to keep awareness. I am pure soul and these are files. I want to finish with equanimity. So now something happens, or say the or file, they say some negative to us, we want to keep equanimity. Some positive words for us, we want to keep equanimity. So no negativity, no attachment, no hatred for our any relative files. We want to finish all karmic account with equanimity. Slowly, slowly, we will practice these five principles. Fifth principle says, whatever relative, our file one, from birth till death, we are getting is our only karmic account. So we don't want to keep now priority for our relatives, relative things, but keep priority for real things. Pure soul, we want to progress in spiritual path. So keep that priority, that importance, that valuation more and more about reality. And relativity, it is going to happen, scientific circumstantial evidence. And it is, we have already brought from past karma, whatever result we are getting, we will finish with equanimity. So we don't want to devalue, but we want to keep awareness, it is going to happen. So not importance for relative, but for real, more awareness, more conscious for relative reality. Relativity is going to happen. I want to finish with equanimity only. Profit or loss. Nobody likes loss, but still he is getting loss in worldly life. So if we are not thinking for profit also, definitely we are going to get profit. So profit and loss, happiness, unhappiness, failure, success, everything is dependent on our past karmic account. And in this life, only scientific circumstantial evidence will give result. So we'll keep awareness for pure soul. Awareness pure for pure soul, and that awareness we can keep constant by practicing five principles, five agnas. And our anger, pride, deceit, greed, we have not finished. But we got, by grace of Dada Bhagwan, directly awareness of pure soul. So that will happen in our business or on family life, anger or pride or deceit or greed, anything happen with any files, then we will keep awareness, oh, this is wrong, I should not do this. So pratikamana. We want to feel sorry for that, we want to do pratikamana for that, we want to wash out our mistake by pratikamana. So slowly, slowly, we will practice five agna. Anybody may hurt, then we will do pratikamana for that. And be in touch with satsang, read Dada's book or videos, whatever available, and touch in satsang group and practice and do that. Charan Vidhi is given to you. That will also helpful for awareness of pure soul. That will give fertilizer, like we can have our awareness will increase by reading Charan Vidhi also. So slowly, slowly, we'll understand this spiritual science and progress in our spiritual path. And every day before sleep, do meditation of I am pure soul, Ish bin rai nizile, soy alma pura, yo soy alma pura. So whole night, automatically you will get that awareness of pure soul, power of pure soul will increase. And next day, whole day, you can utilize that power by practicing five agnas. Again, before sleep, in the night, we'll practice I am pure soul, meditation of pure soul. Remember Dada Bhagwan or Simandar Swami and keep chanting I am pure soul, I am pure soul. That will give you whole night power of pure soul. So like that, this minimum step I explain you, you practice every day, that will give you progress in spiritual path. We'll take some few questions.
Hello.
Yes.
Jai Sachidanand. My name is Rafael. Jai Sachidanand. My name is Rafael. I'm from Brazil. And my question is to keep on the path of pure soul state. It is more about consciousness and practicing the five agnas than actually trying to practice akarma or the selfless good.
Yeah. By practicing five agna and keep separation with Raphael. I am pure soul, Raphael is separate. So that is more than enough for progress in spiritual path or remain in a stage of pure soul. And that akarma or say do selfless good things, it is by intellect we have to practice that. And this is really we are getting who am I. In that stage, we don't know who am I. We are Raphael and we have to practice selflessly. Like that we are practicing. So it is just with intellect we are practicing. Here you are getting really who am I and really who is the doer. There we have to practice something selflessly. So we are practicing, we are doer and we are Raphael. So both the things not helping in path of progress in path of spiritual, as well as we are not getting really state of pure soul. So how can we remain in the stage of pure soul? Here we are getting, I am pure soul, Raphael is separate. And now scientific circumstantial evidence will give some intuition to do work, and circumstantial evidence will come and we will finish the discharge karma with our whatever work coming. So that is, we want to finish our discharge karma with equanimity. So really selfless, really egolessly, we are doing discharge karma, we are finishing discharge karma with equanimity. And inside we are keeping awareness, I am not Raphael, I am pure soul. And whatever Raphael is doing is governed by scientific circumstantial evidence. So by practicing Phayagna and keeping separate with Raphael, that is the best master key for remain in a stage of pure soul. Whatever evidence come, we are saying files. I want to finish with equanimity. So that is also, we are coming in the stage of pure soul.
Thank you. I understand that akarma comes into egoic doer.
Yes.
So we're going before that, yes. Underneath it.
Yes. Jai Sachidananda.
Jai Sachidananda.
Yes.
Soy Nara de Chile.
Jai Sachidananda, I am Nara Miranda from Chile. Can we say that by prevailing as the pure soul, we have found the fifth agna?
Yes. And we are giving valuation for real, priority for real. And we are devalue relative things. We understood that relative things are temporary and it is governed by scientific circumstantial evidence. So now, for relative things, we cannot do anything and we don't want to do anything. We want to do for real thing and we want to progress in real thing. So our effort, real effort for our pure soul. So by practicing Phayagna, as well as you practice fifth agna is also saying we have to practice Phayagna. First part is we have to practice Phayagna. Second part, we want to keep awareness for reality. Do satsang, read Dada's book, go in local satsang also. First priority for live satsang or wherever it is possible, you can join in this live satsang. So this fifth agna is helping to remain in a stage of pure soul. I am pure soul. Correct.
What is the link between the fifth agna and I am the pure soul?
The fifth agna is supporting for I am pure soul awareness. It is supporting because previously our priority is for only relative. I am Nara and I want to do safe side of Nara, protection of Nara. Now you understood I am not Nara, I am pure soul. So our whole understanding is changed. So fifth agna says now keep awareness for reality. I am pure soul. And for Nara, relative things, don't keep any awareness. It is going to happen by scientific circumstantial evidence. So relative thing is dependent on circumstantial evidence. You are not going to do anything for the relative. because all discharge karma, it is going to happen. So keep awareness for reality and real effort for pure soul. So fifth agna showing go towards pure soul and keep priority of pure soul. So satsang is biggest priority. So if we do satsang, if we read Dada's book, if we do charanvidhi, that is priority for pure soul. So it is helping to improve awareness of pure soul, fifth agna. Understood?
Okay. Muchas gracias. Jai Sachidanand.
Jai Sachidanand. Yes.
Hola. Yo soy José de Argentina.
Jai Sachidanand. My name is José Nieva from Argentina. And the question is there a resistance of the ego to become separate, or can we handle it easily? I would like to understand more about the ego.
Egoism will generate due to ignorance of pure soul. So egoism is nothing but total wrong belief. I am Jose, I am doer, I am husband, I am father, I am son, I am engineer, I am doctor. It is all wrong belief. Egoism nothing but collection of all wrong beliefs. So it is total impurity only. So when we get right belief, so it is pure soul. I am pure soul. It is a purity. Now you want to so two type of ego. One is charge ego. One is discharge ego. So after Jnana ceremony, charge ego. So who is charging new karma? That ego gets dissolved. Now discharge ego will remain. Whatever we have charged in past life, that ego will now come in. Discharge effect. So we are now discharge ego will dissolve by practicing five agnas, and charge ego is dissolved by gnan ceremony only. We got gnan. I am not Jose. I am pure soul. So charge ego. I am not doer. Scientific circumstantial evidence are the doer. So I am pure soul. That right belief gets charge ego now gone. It is dissolved completely. And discharge ego will come as the karmic account. Whatever file come, discharge ego will come. We'll practice five agna. I am not doer. I am not Jose. I am pure soul. This is file. This is not my wife. Not my business. This is file. I am pure soul. I want to finish this file with equanimity. So like that, we practice five agnas. Discharge ego is also going to dissolve. So we don't want to dissolve directly ego, but we will practice five agna. We remove all wrong belief. I am not doer. I am pure soul. I am knower and seer. I am not Jose. I am pure soul. That awareness that will give dissolves discharge egoism automatically. We don't want to make much effort to dissolve ego. We want to keep awareness of five principle, awareness of pure soul, who is the doer, who am I, that automatically dissolves all discharge egos. You understood? Yes, Jai Sachidanand.
Good morning.
Jai Sachidanand.
I'd like to know about karmas. If karmas are only individual, or we also carry the karmas of our family tree?
Really, all karma we are suffering from birth to death is really only individual. But we have made affection or attachment or hatred or abhorrence with people. That people will come in this life as a relative members. So whatever karma we have charged is individual, but to whom we have attachment or abhorrence, that person will come in next life. So past life we have attachment or hatred for some person, we have done some anger, pride, deceit, greed with some persons. That attachment, hatred will come that person in this life as a family member. So due to attachment or hatred, we are having these family members. So now we want to finish this family member karma with equanimity. So indirectly, due to our attachment and hatred, these family members are coming in this life. But otherwise, whole, and that is attachment or hatred, is also from our side only. So whatever we have made karma in past life, we have to suffer in this life from birth till death. So it is individual and we have to finish only. You understood?
Sim, entendi. Agradeço.
Yes, I understood. Thank you.
Jai Sachidananda.
Yes,
Jai Sachidananda.
For the immediate effect of ego, the solution after the Gnavidi ceremony, mm-hmm. and a special approach to family members to increase the intention and stay on purpose.
Really, really, our charge egoism is already dissolved in Dhyan ceremony. Because we got understanding, I am not Ceres, I am pure soul. Whatever Ceres is doing is a scientific circumstantial evidence. So we are not doer and I am pure soul. That makes our charge egoism totally dissolve. And discharge egoism, we cannot immediately dissolve. When it will come, any discharge karma will come in action. Family member do some insult. So at that time, discharge egoism will come. We have to practice Vayagna, that anything insult is to Ceres, not with me, I am pure soul. He is inside pure soul. Whatever file we want to finish with equanimity, that awareness will help you to dissolve, discharge egoism. And if we not keep practicing Vayagnas, awareness of Vayagna, discharge egoism will remain pending. And after some times when you keep awareness of five principles, then discharge egoism will dissolve. So discharge egoism slowly, slowly dissolve as the karmic accounts come in practice or in worldly life, whatever, whenever it comes. At that time, we have to dissolve that discharge egoism by practicing five agnas. Understood? Jai Sachidananda.
Understood. My name is Valeria from Brazil, and my question is, how can I achieve self-realization, separate the ego, and see my pure soul in this chaos we live in this mix of work, family, and relationships?
By practicing five agnas, we can achieve this stage, separation of ego, discharge ego, and all this work, family, relationship. We have given five agnas, five principles. Whatever work, family, we have to keep awareness, this is my file. Anything good or bad happen, nobody's doer. Whatever happen in my life is result of scientific circumstantial evidence. Somebody may hurt, then we have to understand they hurt to Valeria, not with me, I am pure soul. So this practicing five agnas, you can remain in a stage of pure soul, and Valeria can finish worldly work, family, relationship, everything she can finish. So by practicing five agna, we can finish our worldly life outside, and inside we can keep awareness of pure soul. You understood?
Sim.
Yes.
Jai Sachidananda.
Thank you. Yesterday, it became clear that we can continue going up step by step and also take this elevator at the same time. How does this dynamic works?
Really, we don't want to say like that. There are two paths. One is elevator and one is step by step. By both ways, people can reach to the path of salvation. And this is not path step by step. This is direct path, elevator path for salvation. So two paths are separate, and both cannot work simultaneously. So when we go to elevator, then we want to leave step by step. So here we are getting elevator path. So now leave step by step, take direct elevator, you can reach to 12th floor directly, no step by step. Understood?
Entendi. Muito obrigada.
Understood. Thank you.
Hey, Sachidananda.